Officials say COVID hospitalizations are higher than at any other point in this pandemic. With ICU beds maxing out, classrooms will also reopen to students tomorrow. There are still lots of unanswered questions in all this. Arwene Haverly has been digging deeper to find answers.
Here in Camas, schools open up to in-person learning starting tomorrow, and all of this is happening as that Delta surge is projected to reach its peak. The situation inside Clark County hospitals is tough and staffs are stretched thin. ICU beds have been running at around 97% capacity in recent days, making matters worse. Projections show hospitalizations rising for at least another 2 weeks. Non-emergency surgeries have been put on hold at all hospitals in Clark County. The reopening of schools is creating a challenge for scientists developing projection models. Last year, very few kids got sick in classrooms in Clark County. Even with the more contagious Delta variant, health officials believe school is still one of the safer places for your kids.
So I'm, you know, cautiously optimistic that even with Delta, which is obviously more contagious and spreads more quickly, with the masking, with the distancing in place, ventilation, all those things that schools are doing, testing to keep kids safe, you know, I'm hopeful that we'll be able to kind of mitigate any large impacts on our case numbers from school.
Staffing shortages at Clark County hospitals are another big concern. Some healthcare providers are temporarily on the sidelines after testing positive. And there's concern over whether hospitals will lose employees when the vaccination mandate for healthcare workers goes into effect at Peace Health. That happens tomorrow. The big challenge right now is keeping people out of the hospital, and county health officials say that vaccinations, masking, social distancing, those are the best weapons right now. But there's also growing evidence that there's some therapeutic medicines that work to keep people out of the hospitals. We'll talk about that coming up at 5 and 6, and we'll also look at a growing number of breakthrough cases in the county. Reporting in Camas, Wayne Haverly, Coin 6 News.